some familiar faces, a lot of friends. Thank you so much for being here with me. It's something that I look forward to doing every year. It's something that's very dear to Marsha and I. But doing this vocal interpretation class, it's something that I don't really do. I don't really do that much of it, but I see that it's in many cases it's needed because I hear so many great voices out there. And when it comes to singing ranchero music, you know, from rancheras valseadas, you know, the 4/4 slow rancheras, huapango sones, sometimes those great voices sort of fall short, you know, of really getting home. I mean, you hear the great, some great instruments, and then you say, well, what's missing here? You know? And I started at a very young age, working in the recording studio. I was at the age of 19. And I was putting a lot of effort into my arranging, a lot of the tracks for local singers in LA. And I soon realized that I was putting more passion into the music, into recording it, than actually the singers coming and doing their vocal parts. I go, I can't believe that I did this arrangement. It was like so over-arranged for the singers that I had. And they were just, they should have been very, very simple arrangements for them. So I had to try very, very hard to get these singers to really fill in the arrangement, because the arrangement was so lush and so, you know, it was pretty well done and well recorded. And I go, wow, these singers are really falling short. How can I do it? How can I get the best out of this person that doesn't have a great vibrato, but also has a great color voice? How can I come up with a concept for them to have a certain style, their own style, that really fits their strengths? And sometimes it's better if you have somebody from the outside letting you know what, you sound better when you do it this way. That's where the artistic direction comes. And I learned that at a very, very young age. And to me, it's really fun to work with singers that are still in that process of trying to find their style that identifies them. Like if there was, for instance, Nidia Rojas, I don't know, some of you know Nidia Rojas. Nidia was 15 when she recorded the first album that I produced for her. Now, she was very, very much influenced by Aida Cuevas. And Aida Cuevas is one of Mexico's great mariachi music singers. She sounded, I mean, like 95% of everything she sang sounded just like Aida. I go, mija, you gotta do this. Look, let's get away from this because that's too much of Aida. I knew Aida because I had recorded with her. So I was trying to find Aida's path, you know, to sing. So that's what we're gonna try to do here. Now, how many of you here are like maybe vocal teachers? Vocal teachers, okay. And how many of you have to work with your students as far as singing? Right? Them singing the songs that you're teaching them. How many of you do have experience singing? Okay, most of you do. So what I'd like to do, I mean, I'd also like to let you know that, you know, all the vocal exercises, the warm-ups, I'm sure that you guys have been through those. I mean, that is so important. Because if you're not careful in mariachi music, you could blow out your voice like that, if you're not careful. Because it's not only the time of the day that they're singing and they're performing, or in the evening, plus, you know, if you're over 21, you add on a tequila or two. So, you know, without us really realizing, we begin to hurt our voice, right? We want to drink something cold. We don't realize that having, you know, drinking, having ice, cold drinks, it's not good because it sort of numbs your cords. Mm-hmm. And it makes you sometimes push more than what you should be pushing when you're singing. Eating sweets right before you sing, really bad. Having sugar because it dries your. She's going, oops. it dries your voice. It dries it up. You know. So that kind of stuff is very, very important. And some of you that can't have dairy, that's not good. That's my brother Chuy. He cannot have a day before, he doesn't eat dairy before he performs. He didn't know that. I go, you know what? Bro, you have to stop eating dairy. Try it. And then, also when I heard him, I go, man, you sound like, your voice sounds like 20 years ago. And it was because he got rid of the dairy the day before. So he does that. So we all try to find, you know, okay, what works for us? So what can we do, you know, to give kids or teachers some good advice for singing that's very, very important. Knowing the text, knowing what the song is all about, very, very important. obviamente, you know, songs like Por Un Amor, Los Laureles, you know, the classics. Hay Unos Ojos. La Malagueña. Cucurru Cucu Paloma. You know, these are classics. Now, knowing what you're singing about, very important. If you don't know Spanish that much, but at least you could try to find a translation of it, of the songs. So you could at least sort of indicate to the kid that does know Spanish, to let them know, you know, what the song means, where it's coming from. Now, that's very, very important. It's hard to teach a kid to sing about heartache because, you know, they have to really use their imagination, you know. You sing something like, por un amor. Me desvelo y vivo apasionado, tengo un amor. So, depending on the arrangement that you're playing, once I put this chord, it sort of guided me to want to sing it a different way, because it made it a little bit more, I think for me, more heartfelt, you know, putting these little substitutes, or, you know, preparation chords, you know, sort of, I don't know, for me it makes it more personal, the arrangement, right? Tengo un amor, this is more ranchero, you know, pero tengo un amor. There's something about that chord that sort of moves me towards the way that I want to say what's coming up. Que mi vida dejo para siempre amargo dolor. Oh, amargo dolor. Still goes with the whole feel of that other E minor chord. All that stuff has something to do with the way that you're going to interpret a song. You know, what I want to do is maybe work with a few of you, to see how much I could get out of your interpretation of the song, and for everyone else to really see what's going on, what I'm doing with their voice. ¿Quiénes son los que cantan aquí? Yo sé que cantas tú, trabajé contigo. ¿Trabajé contigo ya? Did I work with you before?
No.
I want to work with somebody different. También no he trabajado contigo, María, ¿verdad? Voy a trabajar contigo.
Okay,
very nice. Aplauso, por favor. Yes. Víctima número uno. ¿Qué gusto me da verte? ¿Qué te gusta cantar, Marta? ¿Qué conoces de canciones mexicanas? ¿Algo que te sientes más o menos?
Pues única. Me conozco bastante, pero vamos a ver una de aquí, Cariño.
Sí, sí, claro.
Por Un Amor.
Sí. ¿Qué te gusta? ¿Te gustan los boleros o te gustan los rancheros?
La Llorona, la Sandunga.
Sí.
La Malagueña.
Mira. Pues la Llorona, yo pienso que la vas a cantar con
la.
¿Sí?
O bueno.
Todos me dicen el negro.
Llorona, negro pero cariñoso.
¿Cómo?
Yo soy como el chile verde.
Ok. Pero ese tono es más para lo de los niños, right? Es you going your head voice, ¿verdad?
Right.
I want to see where you're at with your chest voice.
That's why, you know, I'm an opera singer, so I'm informed.
Because it sounds beautiful there, right?
Yeah, but I want to know how to.
Exactly, so I'm going to keep it more for your chest voice, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
So we're going to go down to about maybe. Todos me dicen el negro.
Todos me dicen el negro, llorona, negro pero.
Minor, right? I still think to give it more passion, we might go up to F minor. Maybe even G minor. Let's see if you could reach it. Because it goes up to a B flat, you know, okay. Jazz voice.
Ay de mi llorona, llorona de azul celeste. Ay de mi llorona, llorona de azul celeste. Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona, no dejaré.
I think you could really hit the chest voice.
Okay.
See?
Okay.
Now, try not to hit the note and stay there. It's, aunque la vida me cueste, llorona. Aunque la vida me cueste, llorona.
Okay. Y aunque la vida...
Sorry.
Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona. Yeah.
Que la vida me cueste, llorona.
Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona, no dejaré de quererte.
Okay, so your vocal is very, very, you know, even. Mm-hmm. You know, you're taking care of your placement, your voice, works out okay. In mariachi, we get away from that a little bit. Without really leaving the technique of knowing where your voice is at, right? Whether it's chest, head voice, or a mix, or all that stuff, right? Yeah. So, I hate F minor and the vihuela. But F minor would be even better for you. A ver.
Ay de mi llorona, llorona de ayer y hoy.
So, you know, just that phrase. Mm-hmm. Ay. You're putting more emphasis on those words.
Yeah.
You're telling a story, right?
Okay.
You're not thinking
it's
so much
text.
Melody, boom, right, tempo, right? Right. All right?
Okay.
So.
Ay de mi llorona, llorona de ayer y hoy.
Much different?
Yes.
Ay de mi llorona.
Okay, so what you did there? Perfect. The first time, do it simple.
Ay, de mi llorona, llorona de ayer y hoy.
Then, ay, de mi llorona.
Yeah.
See, like, that's not the same both times.
Right.
And it's always, you always have people, wow, okay, you're taking them somewhere, right?
Mm-hmm.
Try that one time.
The second one?
The first, right from the beginning.
Ay, de mi llorona.
Ay, de mi llorona.
Ay, de mi llorona, llorona de ayer y hoy. Ay, de mi llorona, llorona, llorona de ayer y hoy.
Now, volume.
Que aunque la vida me cueste, llorona, no dejaré.
Out of your comfort zone.
Okay.
Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona.
Okay.
Come out of your comfort zone.
Okay.
Okay.
Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona.
No, don't go. You don't have to go.
No.
Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona. Okay.
Y aunque la vida me cueste. No dejaré de quererte. Y aunque la vida me cueste, llorona, no dejaré de quererte.
You hear how she said llorona? She said it in a very, to me, I never heard anybody say the word llorona like she did right now. So that's very much her. That's, you know, I would build off of that to start defining her style of singing. Because the way she said Llorona, she said it in a way that I've never heard it before. And that's what we sort of look for when we're recording somebody. Why? Because when people listen to that on radio or listen to it on CD or now Spotify and all this stuff, right? you want to hear something different, a fresh voice, a different kind of voice. Mm-hmm. So that's what we try to do. It's very much of the commercial singing, but believe it or not, porque es del pueblo, ¿verdad? Estás en el pueblo, oyes al tío Chuy cantando de una manera, ¿verdad? Los mandados de una manera, y luego oyes al tío Beto acá cantando de otra, la misma canción de otra manera, right? There isn't a particular style of singing. Okay, this is the way it's supposed to be done. Everybody has their own personality when it comes to singing. Well, the way you said Llorona, that's part of your, the part of the way that you speak, right? And that's how we try to start defining different ways of singing. And yeah, it's hard to come out of your comfort zone, right?
Yes.
The great thing about it is that when you're in a studio, that you could do one take, you could do another take, you do three or four takes, and all of a sudden, you come, you sit down with the producer or the director, and you start listening to every take, and you say, ooh, I like that. Okay, let's save that one. Boom, you put it, right? You comp it. And then you go to the next four takes. Ooh, I like this one. Okay, boom. You do like one, out of all of the four takes, you do one master take, and all of a sudden, you're just hearing this interpretation. I just said, wow, that's me singing. Yeah, that's you singing it in four different takes. Once you hear that master take, then you get an idea of what's your strength. Because every phrase is your strength out of four plays. And that's how we sort of work into like producing a vocal for a record and stuff like that. But for a kid, too, I mean, it's choosing the right songs for the right kid, right? It's so, so important.
And the right key?
In the right key. In the right key. Well, for you, but fa menor.
Yeah.
It's a little comfortable, for the guitar on and a little dark in the way, but for the kids, we do in A minor. It's perfect. We're just perfect for them. But that's great. Aplauso para ella.
Thank you.
Yeah, so all that is very, very important. Like, right now we're working on a new popurrí that I wrote called El Popurrí de las Marías, right? So I go, I want to do a popurrí that's just dedicated to María, the name María, right? So I go, okay, let's try. Obviamente, María Elena, which is a classic waltz, right? Mm-hmm. Actually, that's been lost. Like, nobody does that anymore, right? María Bonita, probably nobody sings them anymore. And they're the classics, right? But I've always liked the song Maria, the Bernstein song. Maria,
oh, yeah.
Maria, da, da, da. And the Spanish lyric for that is gorgeous. So I figured, okay, we'll put Bernstein with mariachi, no problem. So yeah, we decided to do Maria, going to Maria Elena, going to Maria Bonita. Now, I picked those songs also because I've got two tenors in my group. Man. I got Lupe and I got Ricardo. And I go, man, these songs, they're going to take them, they're going to, yeah. People are going to love the way these guys sing these songs because it's their strength, right? I wouldn't put Chuy to sing Maria Bonita. Acuérdate de Acapulco. No. But Chuy does a trio of Maria, da-da-da-da-da, right? So picking the song for the right singer is very, very important. You're singing. How many of you have like several pretty good singers in your school groups that you guys know? And do they all sing like in a different style pretty much?
Oh, yeah.
Right? Yeah. So you work with picking out songs that sort of fit their strengths, too, right? That's very, very important. Esa de la Llorona te queda muy bien. Te queda muy bien esa canción. We're going to work with María. Talking about María.
Okay.
Now, I heard you sing a little bit not too long ago.
No,
that's the first time I heard you sing, right? So, ¿qué tipo de canción te sientes a gusto? What type of song do you feel comfortable singing?
I like rancheras. I mean, I sing just really like the ones that they always ask for. Amor eterno, los arreles, si nos dejan, aires del mayor.
A ver, vamos a oír un bolero, si nos dejan. ¿Qué
sol?
¿Sol? So we're going to start with that little part of the verse. And what I want to take away from you, si nos dejan, nos vamos a querer toda la vida. I think you did something there.
Yeah.
Let me hear it one more time.
Yeah.
Si nos dejan, nos vamos a querer toda la vida.
That no,
vida.
No. We're going to find a different way of saying it.
Okay.
Nos vamos a querer toda la vida, vida, vida. Vida. Okay? Nos vamos a querer. Toda. Toda la vida. Okay? Nos vamos a
querer toda la vida.
You're out of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
So what you have to try to do is imitate what I'm trying to tell you, eh?
Okay.
Nos vamos a querer toda la vida. Because that note that I'm taking away from you, it's like your comfort note.
Right.
Right? But it takes away from the from your interpretation, that note. Yeah?
Okay.
Si nos
dejan, nos vamos a querer toda la vida.
Much better.
Yeah.
You notice that I took that note away and all of a sudden it just sounds, it feels weird, but it sounds better out here.
Okay.
Now, I need you really to loosen up a little bit more when you're saying the words.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Like, you mean it. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, imagine who you're singing it to.
Okay.
Okay.
Si nos deja, nos vamos a querer toda la vida.
Much better, right? Now, we're going to pause still. Nos vamos a querer. So you're actually back phrasing like three beats almost. But we're not thinking about it. We're thinking about what you're saying.
Okay.
Yeah, okay? Within what's happening musically, right?
Si nos dejan, nos vamos a querer toda la vida. Si nos dejan.
I'm not trying. Si nos dejan.
Si nos dejan.
Eso. Si nos dejan.
Si nos dejan.
Eso, bonito allí. Nos vamos a querer
toda la vida. Si nos dejan, nos vamos
a vivir
a un mundo nuevo. Yo creo podemos ver el nuevo amanecer de un nuevo día.
Yo creo podemos ver el nuevo amanecer de un nuevo día. Get more into what you're saying. Don't,
okay.
You right now you're thinking so much about your note and what's going on here that the whole interpretation is sort of getting lost. You know, yo creo podemos ver
el nuevo amanecer de un nuevo día.
De un nuevo día. Okay.
Yo creo podemos ver el nuevo amanecer de un nuevo día. Yo pienso que tú y yo podemos ser felices toda la vida.
Okay. Now don't do the turn. Yo pienso que tú y yo. You don't have to do that. Yo pienso que tú y yo. Que tú y yo.
Yo pienso que tú y yo.
No, no. Yo pienso que tú y yo podemos ser felices.
Okay.
Yo pienso que tú y yo. Mira, cállate, que si tú me lo estás diciendo, yo te lo digo. Yo pienso que tú y yo. Yo pienso que tú y yo. Pero yo pienso que tú y yo podemos ser felices. Todavía. Estás convenciendo a la persona,
okay.
¿Verdad?
Okay.
Todavía.
Yo pienso que tú y yo.
Yo pienso que tú y yo. Don't worry about the vibrato at the end of the yo.
Okay.
Say the word better.
Okay.
Yo pienso que tú y yo.
Que tú y yo.
Que tú y yo.
Eso, and shorter.
Yo pienso que tú y yo.
No, don't think about singing it. Yo pienso que tú y yo.
Like, soft.
Yo pienso que tú y yo.
Eso, eso. Right now you didn't really think about it.
Yo pienso que tú y yo podemos ser felices todavía. Si nos dejan, buscamos un rincón cerca del cielo. Si nos dejan, haremos de las nubes de
quality of your voice that would sound really good with boleros and ranchero too. Yeah, you just have to find that balance and try to really record yourself and be really critical about how you're saying things.
Okay.
You know, because what I find in a lot of mariachi female singers, they all sort of sound the same. They all sort of sing the same. They all want to do the same vibrato, the same, every note vibrato, it really drives me nuts, right? It really does. Because no, there should be, it's like if we all want to sing like Lupe in my group. No, everyone has their own quality, everyone has their own strengths. And you sort of have to build on that. Like for you, you have to feel more confident to be able to tell the story, you know, the lyric. Because you go, right away you go into your comfort zone, and you, because you feel a little like, you feel a bit nervous about people hearing your voice, right?
Okay.
You just gotta feel more confident. Tienes bonita voz, ¿verdad? Tienes bonita voz. You just, also careful where your placement is. You know, there's a certain note that you can't tune up. What happens when we struggle with a certain note for pitch, on an A or an A or an O, I always have them change the vowel to try to tune it. Like if I say, ah, oh, yeah, oh. If they're like, ah, they're like flat, I go try to say, e, e, they hear it better with an E. Now it's going, yeah. So with the placement, so if you guys try to sing that note, that D, the ah tends to want to go a little flat. So sometimes when we go directly into an ah, and if it's flat, I have them correct it by singing an E or an A. Because have you guys ever gone through that where you're singing and you say, damn it, I know I'm out of tune,
yes,
but why can't I? Well, it's because the placement is not where it's supposed to be, right? So we go to another, right, another vowel to try to correct it, right? So that's why those exercises are so important, right, to be able to control that. So that's how we fix it in the studio, right? There's some guys that really need that help, you know, and some others that really don't need that help. Una, a ver, canta una ranchera, una más movida.
¿El herradero?
Ay, qué linda.
Pero don't cut that off. Ay, qué linda.
Ah.
No, away from that turn. Que traen sombrero ancho. Slur it down better.
Que traen sombrero ancho.
Ancho. Ancho.
Ancho.
Start the vibrato on the O.
Okay.
Y esos charros.
Y esos charros que traen sombrero ancho.
Not the turn. You see how it goes automatic?
It's okay.
Y esos charros que traen sombrero ancho. Okay.
Y esos charros que traen sombrero ancho.
Yeah, yeah. Say, oh, say, oh.
Oh.
Oh, don't think about it. Go, say, eh. You don't have D, D, yo.
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 Ancho.
Ancho.
It's más natural. Right? Because now you're going, esos charros que traen sobre lo ancho. You're doing this. No, and it changes the.
Okay. Y esos charros que traen sobre lo ancho.
Ancho. Mira, oh, esos charros que traen sombrero ancho. But the ancho, don't do that because a billion people sing it like that, right? Ancho. Everyone wants to do a stylistic thing, right? Ancho. There's a place where you probably, I'll let you do that, but not there.
Okay.
Yeah?
Y esos charros que traen sombrero ancho.
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 Ancho!
Ancho!
Ancho! Ancho! I mean, it's great to do it like five different ways. Ancho! 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 I mean, you know, the idea is to do it five, six different ways and be flexible to do it. Because if you only sing one way, everything you're going to sing the same way.
Okay.
That's a whole idea. Of working with people out of their comfort zone and say, you know, you hear a quality in their voice. You know what? This could work. It's going to take a little time.
Yeah.
But once you get that confidence, then all of a sudden the interpretation starts getting better and better and better. It's weird, but when I did Reina's record, se te olvida que te quieres saber. Pues la canta Linda, la trompetista. The girls have never, ever heard her sing a bolero. Ever. Mm-hmm. Because she's got a real pretty voice and stuff like that, but every note must have, se te olvida, que me quieres, hablando lo que dile. Every vibrato, every note, they go, please, no. You know, but I found that there's a certain tenderness in her voice that's really sweet. I go, you know, I go, se te olvida, just say it, soft. Just, we're going to go towards that way. She felt so out of her comfort zone. And it took about 3 hours to do that vocal. But you know what? I like the way it came out. I mean, people could not believe that it was her. Wow, that's you. I don't even think that she's, because they haven't really played that song enough live for her to sing it the way she recorded it. But it's possible to be able to transform someone, for you to know different things that your voice could do without even you even knowing that, wow, okay, I can really do that. Yeah. Muy bien. Tienes bonita voz. Muy bien, María. ¿Quién más podemos trabajar?
¿Quiere
cantar una? ¿Sí? ¿Sí? Claro que sí.
Eso sí. Tiene memoria.
¿En qué tono?
¿En fa?
¿Sí? ¿Quién?
Yeah. Now, my problem is, uh-huh. I also sing opera.
Uh-huh.
And so I'm trying to get a straighter vibrato, use more chest and not so, you know, fluttery highs. So. When I'm singing, I have a higher voice, so when I sing the lower chest voice, it gets a little too much of a vibrato. So what can you do?
Well, let's see what you want. Yeah. You know, I've heard people that have fast vibratos,
yeah.
But they concentrate on what they're saying.
Yeah.
On what they're saying.
Yeah.
That you don't really pay attention to the vibrato because they have you drawn into what they're saying. You're like, what? You know, wow, okay.
Okay.
I could tell you there, Paquita del Barrio is one of them. You know, she's got one of those particular voices that you say, okay, you know, whether you like it or not, it's very commercial. And the way she says the words is what really drives the whole thing. Yeah. And she's got a very fast vibrato, right? Right? So let's... no, you got to be over here. No, you got to be around here.
See, that's a lower chest one. You're gonna test me on that. Okay.
Hay unos ojos que si me mira hacen que mi alma tiemble de amor.
No, I mean,
okay.
No, I think your vibrato's fine.
Oh, okay.
It's not like fast, like, oh my God, stop. I mean, you sing well. I mean, I think it would just be like to try to make it as not as predictable as possible.
Okay.
Right? So let's go to A.
Yeah, that was a little low.
Hay unos ojos que si me miran hacen que mi alma tiemble de amor. Son unos ojos tan primorosos. Ojos.
Now right there, right there. If I hold that longer, I feel like I'm going to go right into a head voice there, and how do I hold on to that chest up there?
You know what? It's that placement. You
okay.
know, it's right where your passaggio is, right?
It is.
It's right
yeah.
there.
Okay.
So a lot of times when I'm arranging for somebody, I try to make sure that I put it in keys where they're right there. I mean, do you feel uncomfortable that you don't know if it's going to crack or do you...
No, not
your
crack.
Your vibrato's fine.
Okay.
You know why? Because it's sort of like that...
Yeah.
That climax part, oh gosh, and you have to hear that. You have to hear a little of that raspiness, you know,
okay.
a little of that teardrop on the voice,
okay.
right?
Okay.
Now,
so
try to say, hay unos ojos. Don't
a
do
little
my
more problem. Delicate.
Don't. just, hay unos ojos.
Okay.
Que si me miran. Then okay. the way you're doing it, just that part.
Hay unos ojos que si me mira.
You see how just by her shortening the first part, how it just, there's something, I mean, it touched me more hearing that. Just
not as predictable.
Not as predictable. You sang it really pretty the first time too,
mm-hmm.
but once you shorten that first, hay unos ojos que si me, because you're very, very melodic. I mean, you're very, you know, it's very lyrical, very pretty when you sing, you know. It's just a matter of finding when to shorten words and not putting vibrato, just saying the word.
Okay.
Saying it with a whisper, with a little teardrop, you know.
Okay.
Try it one more time.
Hay unos ojos que si me miran hacen que mi alma tiemble de amor.
When you did that, now if you notice, I did a tremolo because I would do a tremolo for her to make her feel a little more confident
mm-hmm.
that her voice isn't alone.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm helping her.
Thank you.
It gives you a little sense of confidence. Okay, they're not so like out there, right? Oh God. Try to. I would do it in my key. If I do it in my key, if I go. Oh God, must lead.
Ah.
Try
I'm kind of crying.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try that.
I want you to drop the volume. No he visto yo. Do your right part open.
Okay.
Do the dynamic.
Ojos más lindos no he visto yo.
You know, see? All that, how that hurt, that really
get.
Yeah, there you go. You see? Like all those little things. So it's a director's job to find their strengths. So they could be able to, hopefully, right? It's a director that has taste, right? That says, you know, this sounds better than you. But the idea is for you guys to really feel that. You guys feel that?
Yeah.
You say, wow. Because she has this quality in her voice that you could really, really, really touch people by your voice. It's just taking that extra level, getting to that next level of having somebody guide you, right? To do a vocal that might get there. And that was my job with Linda Ronstadt in her first album.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, because Linda wanted to sing everything like really straight. When she sang this one, man, I told her, Linda, man, it's just like, this is it, man. This take is like the best take. And yeah, we did three complete takes with her. And we did one comp, a bit of everyone, man. And I go, and you know, she didn't realize what she was listening, what was her strength singing ranchero music. I go, don't you feel it? Don't you?
Yeah. Made me feel different.
I'm sad because I don't feel what you're feeling. Yeah. I go, well, trust me, this is where you want to be. Because when she said, oh, God,
yeah.
When she did that, I go, that's where you want it. That's it right there.
Because
there were some real clean ones that she did where her voice placement was just like perfect. I go, no, you want this one. This is the one that, you know, people are going to say, wow, she's, you know. And that's you know, one's job to do that, you know, to try to find a way to get the most out of a singer, right? Somebody, you have a beautiful voice, man.
Thank you.
Applause. Who else wants to take a stab at it? Come on. ¿Quién más canta en español? Poquito. Maestro,
yeah,
Renata.
Voy a ser buena, pues, a little bit.
Sí, contigo, tú cantas también, vamos. Le damos, y luego vamos acá con. Sí. Primero ahí.
There's some guys.
¿Cuál quieres? ¿Ya? ¿Cuál te gusta? Sí. Take is there. All you have to need is a little bit more emphasis on with certain words, right? So, say the words of the first verse.
En aquellos tiempos.
De nuestra juventud.
Mi corazón añora. La juventud de rosa.
Okay. Put more emphasis on what you're saying. More diction, no?
Thank you.
corazón añora. Mi corazón añora. Mas, you have the voice for it, yeah.
En aquellos tiempos de nuestra
notice it too when you're in your sort of head voice, mixed voice, sort of not a full voice. Mm-hmm. Your vibrato, you could do it faster, right?
You
have that quality in your voice. When you open the voice, your vibrato slows down.
Okay.
What you want to do is when you open your voice, keep your vibrato a little more closed up.
Okay. So when did I open the like what?
When I told you to more full,
okay.
Fuller with. Más cerradito, okay? It's all here, you know. I don't know if you do like more of an air stomach vibrato.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
Should be more here.
What am I doing right now?
I think you're doing more, yeah, because if you go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Try it. There you go. It might make you feel out of your comfort zone, but try it. You might feel that it's your vibrato's fast, but it's not.
Mi corazón añora.
That's because you're not full voice right now. Your voice, your vibrato's what I told you. But it's not full voice or vibrato's, you know. It's, okay.
Mi corazón añora.
There you go. Right now you feel comfortable, right? Try it one more time.
Mi corazón añora.
One more time. So you have to practice that.
I don't hear a difference.
Yeah, you don't hear a difference? There's a difference, believe me. There's a difference, right? Yeah. Okay, do the first verse. Probably different than that, but it's an embellishment because it sounds really good on your voice there. At that part of the of your de la tessitura sounds nice for you to do that. También, that's simple. There's different ways of doing it. Like I said, as long as you can do different ways, you have options. You know?
No.
Still hold the note more.
Okay.
Yo sigo enamorado de ti. Yo sigo enamorado de ti.
Eso. You notice it's certain. He did it, not 100%, but it's something that what sounds good in your voice. What?
Separar de ti, solo la muerte.
Nuestro pelo negro.
Well, Seth,
because think of what you're saying, it's really deep what you're saying, right? You're telling the story of, of both of you, right? It's going to be, yeah, nuestro pelo negro.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, nuestro pelo negro. Say it with more passion, eh? Sing out. Ya nuestros hijos viven.
Ya nuestros hijos viven.
No, don't. Full voice.
Ya nuestros hijos viven.
When you do those dynamic changes is when it comes out. You know?
Okay.
And now when you're dropping the voice, I see, with the little turn, it just sounds so much more pleasant, you know, so much more musical.
Okay.
That's the idea. You know, when you're singing this type of music, it's, man, what could I tell you? I mean, it's son canciones. Yeah. There's a friend of mine that passed away about a year ago. A year ago. His name was Memo de Anda. Memo de Anda, cancionero 100% with his guitar, man. That guy, great composer, by the way. He wrote a lot of songs for Vicky Carr, you know, in Spanish. He recorded quite a few songs. One of the most well-known songs that they recorded of his, Miguel Aces Mejia recorded a song called Yo Se Perder. Probably know that. No voy a... No voy a darte más molestias en la vida. Cancionzota. It's, yeah, Memo was, I mean, it's cancionero. De esos bohemios that would come up with lyrics that were really, really heavy. So one day, this is years ago, my nephew Toro, who's now 40, he was, at that time he was like 11 or 12 years old. And they wanted to record an album for him because he sang, since he was 3, he sang like an adult. I mean, he was like a little, like a Michael Jackson, you know, is this a kid sing? That's my nephew, was like exactly like that. And at 3, Vicente Fernandez would see him, he goes, are you kidding me? He would always ask him to sing when he was a little kid, 4 or 5, always singing. El Toro, le dice, mi sobrino, Pedro's son. So I asked Memo to write a song for him. I go, write a song, I want to record this song with him. And I go, the idea is about divorce. Okay, that's the idea of divorce. That he's singing it to his father. That's all I told him. No, the next day he came with a song. He comes and sings it to me, and he brings me, at that time, a cassette, right? Esta se llama un papá nuevo. Ah, China. A new daddy, so that's called. Yeah. A new daddy. Oh, okay. You know? So the song will go, oh my God, when I heard, he had it in a different rhythm, but I changed it to this rhythm. He had it like, I think of bolero, and I go, no, Memo, this is like, yo sé perder, man. This is like real. He's like, let me see. A bit. It's probably here. Ya me voy. No, this is a kid singing, right? Ya me voy de casa. Mi papá ya no nos quiere, porque casi ya no viene, porque dice que mucho tiene de ocupación. Ya me voy de casa, porque siento que mi madre llora solas por mi padre. Cuando cree que no la oigo y me duele el corazón, ya me voy de casa, porque quiero ganar plata y demostrarle a mi papá que yo puedo trabajar. Papá nuevo, que harto quiera mi mamá. Quiero ver a mi mamita con su cara tan bonita, sonreír y ser feliz. Y mis pobres hermanitos que parecen huerfanitos, no los quiero ver sufrir. Ya me voy de casa, porque quiero ganar plata y demostrarle a mi papá que yo puedo trabajar para ganar mucho dinero y comprar un papá nuevo que harto quiera mi mamá. Now you can imagine a 10-year-old or a kid, or a 6-year-old or a 7-year-old.
Wow.
Little boy or little girl singing that song. But these are songs that you have to, you get, the lyric has to drive you, right? So you put that sort of same, those same rules in effect when you sing any other song. You have to sort of believe in that story. Siendo los laureles, siendo hay unos ojos, siendo por un amor. Mariachi is not really about singing an old, oh, what beautiful placement he had there. Oh, it was just so crisp and so quick. It's not that. It's like, does the song get to you? Does it hit home? You know, do you want to have a tequila after you hear it? But you know, that's sort of like the idea of you want to get to that place where people hear you sing, people hearing you interpret a lyric, and you say, wow, that's heavy. That song, to me, I mean, it's one of the, you know, one day you know what happened? My nephew never recorded it because his voice changed.
Oh.
So, you know.
Ya me voy de casa.
Doesn't sound the same, right? You know, but that has to be like for just a kid that has a heavy-duty voice, no? Yeah, great voice, you know. That's the idea. Vamos a trabajar contigo, a ver.
Okay.
Aplausos acá.
No sé, ¿alguien tiene alguna
pregunta? ¿Qué te sientes a gusto?
Lo que sea, un ranchero, no sé si quieres cambiar estilo o estilo.
Sí, es un buen ranchero.
A ver. Ella.
¿Ella? ¿Por ahí? ¿Eh? Ok, ahí. ¿Encima?
¿Ya? Entonces, ok. No.
Me cansé de rogarle. Ok.
Me cansé de rogarle. Me cansé de decirle que yo sin ella de pena muero. Ya no quiso escucharme. Si sus labios se abrieron, fue para decirme, ya no te quiero.
Okay, let's hear it in B flat. Let's see where you're at.
Me cansé de rogarle. Me cansé de decirle que yo sin ella de pena muero. Ya no quiso escucharme. Si sus labios se abrieron, fue para decirme, ya no te quiero.
What a big difference in that key, huh, for him.
Yeah.
¿Sí?
Yeah.
A ver en dónde.
A ver. A ver, en dónde no voy. Me cansé de rogarle. Me cansé de decirle que yo sin ella de pena muero.
It's a whole different take, right? It's not what I mean. It's a whole different take.
Yes.
For him there.
Sí.
But honestly, I really like it in B-flat for him. The interpretation of B-flat is a little different. It's it's less aggressive, and I would even maybe sí. Change a little bit of keys. It's más, más melodiosa en sí, amor.
Is it because I guess donde está, que I
have to lechas, kind of, sí, sí, lechas, es que va con la interpretación, yeah. Which sounds good too. But I like with the color of your voice where it's at in B-flat.
Me cansé de rogarle. Me cansé de decirle que yo sin ella de pena muero. Ya no quiso escucharme. Si sus labios se abrieron, fue para decirme, ya no te quiero. Yo sentí que mi vida.
So when you're doing those low, yeah. That you feel they're low?
Yeah.
More, it's like more of a talking voice. Yo sentí que mi vida. Don't try to sing it because then it'll close up on you.
Okay.
You have to be more natural. You okay. Gotta be more
mas,
natural.
Mas a...
Yo sentí que mi vida
se perdía en un abismo profundo y negro como mi suerte. Quise hallar el olvido. Pero aquellos mariachis y aquel tequila me hicieron llorar.
Very good. When you say Jalisco, say it a little longer. Al estilo Jalisco. Pero a little longer because it's like I'm really getting into your voice. I go, órale, and then all of a sudden you cut off the noise.
Okay.
Do you guys feel that sometimes?
Yeah.
It's sort of,
so on this part?
Órale, se oye bien. Yeah, sí, claro, claro. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
A ver, me cansé de
rogarle. Me cansé de rogarle. What's the next
line? A ver. Con el llanto en los
ojos, alcé mi copa y brindé. Era el último brindis de un bohemio con una reina. Los mariachis callaron. De mi mano sin fuerza cayó mi copa sin darme cuenta. Ella quiso quedarse. su amor.
Yes, perfect. And also, you're más escandalosa tu voz, poquito,
sí,
¿verdad?
Como que.
When it's B-flat, it's just like, when you get to this part, it's just perfect because you still have it under control and there's a, it still has a nice color to it. When you go,
Ella quiso quedarse cuando vio mi tristeza.
You know, so he could reach it.
Yeah.
But it's gotta change.
Más.
Sí.
Ella quiso quedarse cuando vio mi tristeza. Pero ya estaba escrito.
This is a lot more brighter, right? A little thinner.
Yeah. Sí.
Here, still the color is there, you know, for me. The mariachi sounds darker, right? Because it's in the key of B flat. So the sound of the mariachi would be a little darker, even because of the key. Okay. But your voice, which is a principal thing, is better in B flat.
B flat.
Sí.
Okay.
A ver, canta alguna otra cosa. ¿Qué?
A ver.
¿Qué cantaste la última vez? ¿Un bolero? Did you sing a bolero last time?
No. Se me hace que cante las ciudades.
Okay. Las ciudades.
A ver, canta un bolerito.
A ver. ¿De qué manera te olvido?
Sí. Un bolero.
Verás que no he cambiado, que estoy enamorado tal vez, igual que ayer. Quizá te comentaron que a solas me miraron llorando tu querer. Y no me da vergüenza que aun con la experiencia que la vida me dio,
of a song?
Yeah.
See? A ver,
well, let's try that.
Venga, sí.
Great. I'll do that.
Let's try it.
Yeah, I'll get it. Unless you don't want me to. Well, at least we'll get it out there and then I can send it to
my voice. My voice is low.
Okay. So. ¿Qué canción? ¿Qué canción, Marcos?
A la manera.
Ah, sí. Yo me canso.
Yo me canso de llorar y no amanecer. Ya no sé si maldecirte o por ti rezar. Ya no quiero,
tengo miedo de buscarte
y de encontrarte. amigos que te vas.
Okay, so he's got more, you have more of a commercial type of voice. So what we have to find is, you have to just enunciate a little bit more. Pronunciar las palabras poquito más y cantarlas hacia afuera poquito más. Because I wouldn't want to take away, there's a certain character that you have when you sing, you know. Ya me canso. To me, it's very heartfelt. I don't know, there's something about it. Ya me canso. De llorar, very personal, you know. But you have, tienes que aclarar las palabras.
Ya me canso de llorar y no amanecer.
Okay, now. Ya me canso. No voy para mal eso.
Ya me canso de rogar, de llorar y no amanecer.
Siga.
Ya no sé si maldecirte o por ti rezar. Tengo miedo de buscarte y de encontrarte. Donde me aseguran mis amigos que te vas.
See, so there's something about his vibrato that's very different. Now, what I would work with you, obviously, is on the timing of the songs. So right now, the time, you're a little bit off of the timing, but you do, you have a certain character to your voice that's different. I mean, it's a voice that I haven't heard anywhere. You know, something that happened. Usted tiene esa voz también. Es una voz muy, muy distinta. Son voces muy particulares. La de usted, la de él, y la de la señora. Tiene una voz muy particular. Tienes una voz muy, muy... No muy usual también, tú, no vos. O sea, todos tienen algo diferente. Everybody has like their own style of singing, which is great. That's the whole idea of this class, is to see what we could do with a different style. Mm-hmm. But you would definitely be a challenge to work with. It would be really cool to do something like a Paloma Negra. I mean, even, a ver, ya agarraste.
Yo agarraste.
Yo.
Ya agarraste.
Agarraste.
Yeah.
You see how you got it, because he changed it to E?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's sometimes, because especially people that don't have a lot of experience singing, they have problems with sometimes with placement and it doesn't help their pitch any, right? So that's the way you fix it. You just try it with another vowel or something. Yeah. All that stuff is
right. Yeah.
Right there, you did it again. You went flat. Say.
Yeah.
¿Te sabes algo?
Sí.
¿Cualquier cosita? No importa.
No me parece nada, pero no estaba pensando que iba a cantar.
Ese es el chiste. De improvisar.
¿Qué gustas escuchar?
No sé. ¿Qué te sientes más a gusto tú?
Pues canto las que piden, más o menos. Sí. Pero quizás un bolero.
¿Un bolero?
Pues estamos tocando también, ¿qué? Pero también estamos tocando las de sombras, porque,
¿sí?
Porque aquí lo estamos estudiando de todos modos.
Quisiera ver lentamente las veras.
Sí.
A ver.
Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas, mi sangre toda, verte en las tus pies, para poderte demostrar que más no puedo amar, y entonces morir después. Y sin embargo, tus ojos azules,
okay, so when Y sin embargo, mira, quisiera ver, dime la letra.
Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas.
Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas, ¿ok? Quisiera abrir, no voy a hablar, okay. Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas, a ver.
Quisiera abrir.
No, quisiera abrir, eso.
Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas.
Eso es, venas. Okay. Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas.
Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas.
See, so how you say it has a lot to do how, you know, the delivery, right? So you sometimes you need somebody from the outside to start telling you, say, you know, if you say this in this way, it's going to help you. Because then you have a fast vibrato. Mm-hmm. You hear your vibrato. Your vibrato's fast. Now, you have, there's a vibrato that's from the stomach. I don't know if you ever tried it. That comes from down here, which could slow it down. People that have fast vibratos and they want to slow it down, that's what they do. They change it to here. So they'll do it's almost a breathy kind of vibrato. Mm-hmm. Quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas. That kind of vibrato. Very Bee Gees.
The Gibbs. Sounds like the Gibbs.
Bee Gees, you know? Exactly. So a lot of times they look for different ways of doing things like that or saying things, saying them.
Okay.
Example, Lucha Villa is one that didn't really have, she was very uncomfortable with her vibrato. So her whole idea of singing was very, really telling a story and making almost like certain noises of the way that she would say certain lyrics, you know? So she would say like, a medias de la noche te soñaba. She would say that. She would say, a medias. De la noche. No. She was, a medias. De la noche. Te soñaba. And that was enough to say, wow, orale, Lucha, you know. She didn't need to do the Lola Beltran was a whole different animal. Right, you know. So you have to sort of find a way of, okay, which way, how can I do this to sound, you know, as comfortable as possible. Do what you want to do, right? So when you quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas. It's almost like if you're playing an instrument, right?
Yeah.
But you're sort of singing it melodically, even trying to sing it without the words first to say how would I embellish this? You know, when I'm singing, playing, and you start working with different ways and recording yourself and seeing. Yeah. Being your worst critic.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the best way of doing it, right? Because, you know, some people, there are triple players that don't sing. They don't sing. You know what? I'm more of a player. But I want to know in which way I could do it because sometimes you could come across as a director. Not all directors are singers. Mm-hmm. Not all of them. There's just some that have great vision, but they're not singers. But they're great at noticing when somebody else, you know, why don't you try it this way? This is, you know, see? Muy bien. Muy bien. Anybody else want to try something? Or you have any questions?
I have a question.
Yes.
Maybe a technique question. So when kids are singing, because they're not very comfortable with that speech singing, Michael sort of mentioned it at the beginning, our beginning level class today, it's kind of as if to say, my darling, I love you. Da 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 da. And if you speak it, then you say, okay, now let's take that speech, okay, and let now take what you just said poetically, and now turn that into the melody. Take that and just fold it into the singing part.
That's basically what I try to tell them. It's kind of,
So maybe they could speak it, you know, kind of act it.
See?
And then I noticed when Felipe was singing, you know, his hands go up and all that kind of stuff. And I would think that would help you, wouldn't it, to have some body motion, because standing still and singing is a choir thing, kind of, but it's hard to stand still and sing, Melina, right?
It's a little confidence.
Yeah, because you're not like, oh, you know, but I mean, right?
Yeah.
Man, the whole acting thing really helps too.
I think that would help a lot.
I see people come out of their shells, you know.
Yeah.
Fernando, one of the guys in my group, I mean, he was, when he came, you know, beautiful voice, and wow, but man, it was like a piece of ice, you know. And I go, hey, Fernie, man, you should take some acting lessons. That'll help you, like, feel a little bit more confident about what you're saying. And yeah, he did. He took acting lessons. Man, it helped him so much. Even when he needs to do this, when he's singing, instead of standing there, he could stand there. The mariachis, a lot of mariachis still, you know, they still sing like mariachis, you know. They don't sing like an artist. And when you're up there and you're the front person of that song, you gotta make people feel that you're an artist.
See, and I think I'm always stuck behind the guitar. So well, I'm not used to.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah,
you're singing
wrong.
You're playing with guitar.
Right. I play, so it's kind of like my.
Well, that's a
your security
special
blanket.
Situation there, right? Yeah. But you have to make people feel that they're watching an artist when you're singing. Mm-hmm. You know? No, un mariachi está cantando. De la sierra por él. Doesn't care what they think of him singing. But when you're singing and you know what, I want to see if I could make these people, you know, feel something here. Yes?
You were talking about your nephew, that his voice changed. Do you work with students at that time when the voices are changing? Because I tried to help somebody. He wanted to do Vicente Fernandez so bad that he couldn't do it. He couldn't even find the note because his voice is changing. It's like almost he doesn't even hear it. Mm-hmm. He didn't even hear it, so he didn't know how to correct it.
Yeah. You know, technically, I don't know. I would really just stay in his comfort zone. I wouldn't want to push it. I mean,
no.
It's probably like all over the place when they have that break and they're going through that whole break and it's changing.
It is. So I just took down the octave, and that's all I could do.
Yeah.
You know.
There are certain situations of singers that they've sung through that whole thing. I mean, I asked Luis Miguel, like, well, how do you do it? Like, ¿cómo le haces? You know, like, you sing like 5 nights a week, 2 hours. You've seen the show.
Oh, yeah, right? Yeah.
I've seen him do like 30 nights in a row, you know.
And
you know, I see him warming up. He goes, ooh. I go, who told you those exercises? He goes, you know what? Honestly, I sort of worked myself what makes sense in my head and for my instrument. He goes, but when my voice was changing, my dad didn't give me any rest. My dad made me sing through my whole change of voice. Mm-hmm. And it stayed. I kept my range up.
Oh, yeah.
That's what he said. Word for word.
Well, yeah, but you know, what he did was, he didn't necessarily have him singing selections. He had him singing, which means, like, if you keep singing up in your head voice and down as low as you can, just keep vocalizing. And, you know, because kids will be able, even if they're going through the change, boys can still sing up in the head and pull it down. As long as they're, you know, what's the word I want to say, audiating. You know, as long as they're doing something, just to keep the voice going, because eventually they'll come out of it.
If you keep him in tune with this, if he has a falsetto voice, I don't know if he does.
Yeah. No, he didn't. No.
He lost all that too?
He lost all that too.
Yeah, he did.
I've seen
choral directors actually do a technique where they, stand up a second, I want to show you something. Okay, this is a choral technique I saw where the choral person said, all right, like, so I'm singing, ah, and the boys are going, ah, they sing down a fourth. It's the weirdest thing, and they parallel you, right? Okay, so I go, ah, sing down a fourth. Ah, good, okay, good. So I'm going to do this. Okay, we're going to have you rev up that sound until you find my voice, okay?
You still want me down the fourth.
When they start to find it, did you hear it lock like that?
Yeah.
It's amazing how when they find it, they get it. Now they feel where it's supposed to be.
Uh-huh.
So and that's a great little technique when the boys are singing down below you a fourth all the time, you know. But that try that song. If you have that problem, and what you will with boys, you know, especially a woman singing, because we're, you know, a man, when a man sings with a guy, it's a little different. But they always want to sing, you know, in the wrong octave and all that. It's just weird. Good job, Tim.
Yeah. You locked in.
Yeah.
And yeah, let's it's very important. Yeah.
So speaking of working with the young voices, how do you make sure, like you said, they can blow out the voice really easily? How do you make sure that they're singing stylistically appropriately, but they're not?
You know, when they're very young, I mean, like what we did with Canta Mariachi Canta, we sort of keep them in their head voice, just to play it safe, you know. At that age, just head voice, so they could know their head voice. You know, that's, everybody's it's a different story with everybody, you know, with their voice. You know, they just have a different instrument. You just have to know what you're hearing as far as if they're pushing, if they're hurting their voice or not. And, you know, trying to change keys, you know, sometimes you have to do that. I think that's the biggest.
I think so.
That's the hardest thing right now, because I hear a lot of kids. I mean, I think they're hurting their voices a lot, because a lot of songs are in the wrong keys. Mm-hmm. And girls, especially, they're singing like in voice keys. Yeah. They're saying, oh my God, what's going to happen to her voice? I'm thinking, oh my God, she's only 14. What's going to happen when she's 19 or 20, you know? You know, you have to just make wise choices and pick the right type of repertoire in the right keys.
And it will come.
What are their ages? 6th
through
8th
grade, so
11
through 14.
11 through 14, they're right at that.
That's huge.
Just, sometimes if they could still sing, you know, their head voice, I mean, I know my son, when he went through that, he was nowhere near that. He was like, duh. Ahí pareces becerro. You know, so I would keep him an octave lower, you know, just play it safe. Don't hurt yourself. See where you're at. See, can you do? Could you make this? Oh, could you make that noise? You know, it's like totally gone. You know, so just keep them an octave lower from everyone else.
There's an app called the Amazing Slow Downer. We'll take anything that you have and we'll put it in any key and won't change the tempo.
Yeah, that's awesome.
It's a great app. Mm-hmm. Amazing Slow Downer.
It's hard though because there's so much.
Yeah.
Could you say a little something about how you put together trios and quartets?
Mm. Ooh, you know, the old school way? The old school way is, this is listening to progressions. Like for instance, in D. I don't know what, just pick any bolero, pick whatever. I don't know, whatever.
Sabor a mí.
Sabor a mí. Tanto tiempo disfrutamos, tanto tiempo disfrutamos de este amor. I'm hearing that within these chords. So. I'm just filling in the triad, you know, but I'm hearing. Sabor a mí. I'm not going sabor a mí. Sabor a mí. I'm staying within that fourth or that third, because I know I'm either a fourth down or a third down if I'm the second voice, and if I'm the third voice, I'm singing either in sixths, right? Sabor a mí. Sabor a mí, as opposed to sabor a mí. That's sort of, it's in the chord, but it doesn't sound pleasant. Sabor a mí, right? Can you do that? Sabor a mí,
sabor a mí,
sabor a mí,
sabor a mí,
sabor a mí. Sabor a mí.
Sabor
but want to make it sound a little bit more. Sabor. Second part.
Sabor.
I'm adding the ninth. And it still sounds good because it's sort of like what we call an extension polychord. Now that goes into knowing chords also, right? Harmony, modern harmony. But yeah, the trios, I don't know, we improvise trios like for fun.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, my dad never sat me down. Mira, discos porque este es lo menor y no para ver. Never. ¿Qué no oyes, pendejo? The hard way. Hear where the chord is going. And by just listening, that even helped me, you know, improvise segundas, the trumpet, terceras. I have no problem playing third trumpet without even practicing a part. You know, sometimes they're playing like, they'll go from thirds to sixth, first and second trumpet, and I'm filling in the gaps. You know, I'm not doing your just standard three-part harmony like when you write it out. Sometimes I'll jump from a third to a segunda, third, you know, to try to fill in the gaps when they're doing it. But that's just listening. Hablando claro, I've never done it in trio, but you go. So if I do hablando claro, siento en el alma, you sing it first.
No,
I'm just learning
it. So do you know
it? Siento en el alma, muchas
ganas.
Siento en el alma.
Okay, sí. Siento, mira. Siento en el alma, muchas ganas de llorar. Pero no lloro porque tengo mucho orgullo. Has destrozado este amor que fue tan tuyo. No vas por irte por el mundo aventurar. You understand what I mean? So I'm filling in the third part, right? Now I'm going to change the third part, right? Sing it. But sing it with rhythm. One.
Siento en el alma muchas ganas de llorar, pero no lloro porque tengo mucho orgullo. Has destrozado ese amor que fue tan tuyo. No vas por irte por el mundo aventurar.
And then it was, that's what the trio is like, the los tangos, you sing that kind of trio. Not so straightforward, ranchero, no?
Yeah.
Right?
That's
now you sing third.
Siento en el alma muchas ganas de llorar, pero no lloro porque tengo mucho orgullo. Has destrozado este amor.
So it's pretty much parallel, right? So it's not that difficult.
Now I know.
Yeah, right? Or you do another one. Hay unos ojos que si me miran. Hay unos ojos. Hay unos ojos.
Hay unos ojos que si me miran. Hacen que mi alma tiemble de amor. Son unos ojos tan primorosos. Ojos más lindos no he visto yo.
I'm just making it, sort of completing that, those triads.
Yeah.
Right, it's sort of a form of listening, and the more you try to do it, push yourself to listen, all of a sudden you find yourself harmonizing with just any. You hear somebody, and all of a sudden you're harmonizing, doing a second voice or a third voice. Now going into four part, that's totally that has to be written out. That's doing that kind of stuff. And then transfer it, takes it.
With your solecitos, I noticed, like, what is that canción? You guys had a song when you guys, is it, you find it easier with students to when you're doing two voices, to use sixes, parallel six I think that's is that probably better to start them off like when you're canting.
Either thirds or sixths. It works. I try to keep them there or what, unisons.
What is the canción que se
Cariño,
no,
y,
tan,
oh.
tan,
en
un camión pasajero.
Sí,
son ahí sus
ojos.
Ajá, los
papás
están
sí.
Porque ahí está la niña cantando arriba en ella estaba cantando.
Sí.
Six, the whole, pretty much
sí.
the whole time.
Yeah. Ajá, porque lleva la mera melodía. She's actually singing la segunda arriba.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes
yeah.
We'll, you could turn them around. You have that option
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
You know?
We're in the intermediate and we're working on the law. That's a hard two-part harmony that we haven't been able to get.
That's going
to
depend on the chords that you have, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know what chords you have.
Yeah.
What key is it in?
G.
In G? For a girl, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. And Bridget, yeah, we're
all. Who sings it, man?
And that's
the other
thing. They have me singing it up an octave. That seems too high.
They want us to drop it.
Yeah,
they
just
want us to drop
it. Yeah.
Yes. You know, if you sing the melody,
Reno,
no
marque
la
soda.
It's right there where it's supposed to be.
Yeah, for men. For men.
No, men is in D.
Oh, no, no,
men is
yeah.
in D. Pero no marques la sola.
Yeah.
This is for women in chest voice.
Pero. Okay, so it should be down to octave. Yeah,
yeah.
Just
there.
But here it's written, you know it's written high. So I was just like reading it.
No, no, no.
I've never seen this before.
Yeah.
So it goes down wrong.
Yeah.
Okay.
So there, like if you're doing trio, reloj,
yeah.
reloj, reloj, no marques las horas.
Yes, please sing it.
Porque voy a enloquecer. Tenía sueño para siempre. Cuando amanezca otra vez. It shouldn't bother you to hear a second or a third harmony at all. Yeah, there's some people that they sing well and then ooh, they hear a harmony, all of a sudden they go unison with the harmony.
Yeah.
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 Can you teach rolling your R's?
Rolling? I don't know. Can you go?
No, I can't.
Right.
My wife always tries to teach me. I always look dumb. I'm sitting at dinner going.
Can I say something about that?
Yeah.
My students ask me that, and I tell them to go like this.
His question.
You have to move to Mexico for 6 months and he wants to get food. Maestra, we got a candidate here.
Yeah.
Got a question. When you harmonize the, you do the third voice, it's just, you do a fifth, you do just this, what are you?
Sometimes, like, we go back to what influences you, the kind of trios that you listen to, you really have to find the trio that you like and the style of their harmonization. You have los trios, los panchos, that were more traditional. You have trio los haces that were more progressive. That's Sol is very much trio los haces, you know. Los tres reyes, I mean, there's so many, you know. It depends how you want, how you, where the harmony sort of take you, right? It just, it depends where, you got to give me an example of a song and then I'll give you the example of a harmony, right? You know, there's some songs that are more difficult because the chord changes are more.
For example, Camino de Michoacán.
Well, that's not a trio song, but I mean, I don't mind doing it. Can you do a trio on Hema?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Which is?
Hema.
Hema? Aquí para José. Como piel de preciosa, como divina joya, varios de ver. A ver. Tú. A ver. Tú.
Como piel de como divina joya.
Oh yeah. See, you're singing the third. You're singing the natural six, like a second trumpet, right? So it just depends. You know what I mean? You gotta know where you're filling in the chord. Tú, tú, como piedra preciosa, como divina joya. So it's more of a free lead, right? Either tu, 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 sing up. Tu, 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 como piedra preciosa, como divina joya. Tu, como piedra preciosa, como divina joya, valiosa de verdad. So if you guys aren't sure, yeah, what's going to happen with us? Tú como piedra preciosa, como divina joya, valiosa de verdad. A ver.
Tú como piedra preciosa, como divina joya.
Okay, sing it out loud now. For me to sing third when I don't hear the rest of the chord, you know. So everybody's got to be sort of on the same page on filling in the gaps of the chord. You got to hear. See, now mechanically I'm telling you your part. The idea is for you to hear them.
Yeah.
Tú, como piedra,
Tú, piedra preciosa.
Eso, mira.
Tú, como piedra preciosa, como divina joya.
You see how all of a sudden it works?
Sí, yeah.
Because you see where it peels off, but you got to be able to hear that.
Yeah.
Where you're going to start at?
If it's hard for, you know, us to, that if some of us don't do harmonies, it's hard for us. Can you imagine? I've been trying to teach harmony to even fifth and sixth and seventh and eighth. Fifth and sixth, they don't quite get it at all, even the two-part harmony. They keep on wanting to sing, you know, they branch off for a little while in harmony, then they go to the melody. So
no,
you
but,
keep them on their own.
For me, the most important thing is to teach them solfeo.
Okay. Yeah.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
And get them used to hearing thirds.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
And the thirds, yeah, through exercises. Mm-hmm. It's just for them to find their comfort zone and listening to it. Because once they hear that, it's not going to bother them to hear a third. I realize that with my kids. I know my kids sort of have music in their blood, but I got them used to really hearing harmonies. The twins, I worked them, taught them different than I taught melody. Melody, I didn't teach solfeo. I taught solfeo to the twins. Mm-hmm. And their ears are so much more advanced than Melody's ear, anything. I mean, they hear like first, second, thirds, and they have no problem sticking to a harmony. Melody has problems. She'll, then unless she starts hearing it a little bit more, then she'll do harmonies like just nonstop. But she'll take longer to do it. Yeah. So yeah, you have to sort of just force. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
So I will go.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
Hear them. You know, we didn't go do, re, mi. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la. Do, re, mi. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la. Hola. I wouldn't do that. Three-part harmony in the key of C. You wouldn't have that A, the six, you wouldn't, which is of the chord. You wouldn't, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do.
Oh, yeah.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, do. You would have that. As opposed to, what happened here, you know? It's just try to get them through exercises to hear thirds. Because, yeah, well, once you put them, like, beginning with a song right away, I think it would be a lot harder.
Okay.
You know, just get them to
train their
ears. Yeah, train their ears, yeah.
I'm a flute player. I know how to sing, but I need to learn how to sing so I can teach my kids.
Uh-huh.
I kind of know L, right?
Yes.
I would love to hear.
Okay. I have to look at lyrics.
Okay, let's go.
Sure.
Venga, sí.
All right.
Oh, gosh.
I don't know. What do you think?
Well,
it depends what your voice is. I don't know where your voice is at. Yo sé bien que estoy afuera. Okay, try to be. Yo sé bien que estoy afuera. Pero el día que yo me muera, sé que tendrás que llorar.
Sé que tendrás que llorar.
So I think what helps is reading it through it with a lead sheet. I don't, do you guys have like a lead sheets of these songs or no?
Yes.
The main melody?
Yeah.
All right? So once you have the melody, you're sure of the melody, right?
Yeah.
That's, you got to have that sure before you start looking at the lyrics.
Okay.
But actually, you have a nice voice. Don't you have a nice voice?
Michael helped me. All
right?
Okay.
Yo sé bien que estoy afuera. Pero dije que yo me muera, sé que tendrás que llorar.
Llorar y llorar, llorar y llorar.
Dios que no me quisiste.
Dirás que no me quisiste.
Dirás que no me quisiste.
Okay.
Fala.
Okay. Dirás que no me quisiste. Okay, one more time. Dirás que no me quisiste, pero yo estoy estar muy triste, y así te vas a quedar.
That just has a natural vibrato, you start using that kid as an example
for
the other one and say, this, listen to him, sing this little part for him. This is sort of the direction that we want to go, okay. Right? If you feel, okay, I don't have the mariachi vibrato, but this kid does, come here, get over here, right? So I think that's like the best way of doing it.
Okay.
You know? But you definitely have a nice voice. Yeah. You just have to, I don't know if you have, do you have a vibrato? Do you sing at home and get vibrato sometimes?
Try.
Una piedra en el camino. Una piedra en el camino.
Where's that?
Right after.
Okay. Una piedra en el camino.
Una piedra en el camino.
Una piedra en el
camino. Pero sigo siendo el rey. Can you sing the part?
Pero sigo siendo
el rey.
Pero sigo siendo el rey.
There you have it.
Okay.
You just have to let it. You have to let it go. You have to let it go.
Pero sigo siendo
rey. There you go, but there you go. It cracked in the beginning, right? But the thing is, you have to just practice it so you can feel comfortable once you let the vibrato go.
Okay.
But you haven't. It's not a real fast vibrato. It's
okay.
Está bien, ¿verdad? Oh. Wow.
People who don't have a vibrato, they want to develop one. I mean, you say you just let it go, but how do you have any?
The thing is, the vibrato, the natural mariachi vibrato is, it's la garganta.
Uh-huh.
Ah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, nobody taught me how to do it. It just sort of came out, right?
Yeah,
I think everybody sort of has a, can we all like, and E. Out on it. You just let it go. Do a deep. There it is. You have it there. It's just a matter of you practicing it. Just say, oh man, you make it seem, you know, some scrambled eggs. Ay, huevos.
Here.
So try, yeah, let it. It's a little too wide right there, you know.
Hi. Trying to make it faster.
No. Don't think about the speed of it. Just let it out.
Hi.
One more time. But I started pushing here to slow it down.
You Tarzan, me Jim.
Okay.
Good one.
Yeah, it's a matter of just listening to yourself and then finding a certain comfort zone. Let it out. play.
Okay.
Sí, es rapidito, pero es agradable. Steady.
Okay.
You know, everybody has their natural vibrato. It might be fast, it might be slower, it might be right in the middle. Yeah? Full voice. Ahí está, ahí está. Ahorita te salió al final, otra vez. Ahí está. Ahí está.
Just say no.
There it is. Try it one more time. Say it.
Oh my God.
Now try it here. And try to think that it's from here. A little while, you have to, it's there. You just have to experiment, and find it. Because if you go, this kind of vibrato, it's going to be for a mariachi, it's really difficult for it to. Try. At the end it came out. There it is, one more time. You probably feel that it's going really fast. But it's not. It's very, very, you have a very nice vibrato. It just has to be consistent. There it is. What a nice voice. He's got nice voices.
That's a big one.
Wow.
Wow.
Tequila. Okay, next. Just to start it off, you have it.
I was trying to be nice. I'll do it.
See, dimmer. See, dimmer. One more time. Now try to slow it down. See if you can slow it down. Towards the end, you slowed it down. So it's just a matter of going over and over and record yourself and say, that's where it's at, that's the way it feels, that's how it sounds, okay, that's where I'm at. Yeah? So you have it there. It's right now you feel like it's shaking or it's gonna crack on you, right? Try to keep it as steady as you can. Your natural
Thank
voice.
You.
Do
he wasn't. That's it.
Ready?
Much better.
It'll come up. It's there. I hear it already. It's there.
It's coming.
I'm
I can really hear it.
I hear it.
Too. Mm-hmm. That's good.
You have a nice vibrato. It's just right now, it's like, right?
You
have a nice vibrato. I heard it, so it's there. You're going to have that.
Our vibrato comes from our diaphragm.
Yeah.
So that's when I'm like, ha, ha, ha.
It's like when you play the flute.
Yeah.
When you from there I know. When you're playing the flute, but you have the sound of the vibrato in your ear.
Yeah.
That's what you're trying to achieve with just with this.
Have you seen?
You see, and what you're trying to do, you're trying to achieve it, and you're letting it out. That's what you have to continue doing until you find your comfort zone there. It was a little bit of it that it did come out. So we all have the vibrato. The thing is that we don't experiment enough. You know, when you're alone in your room, you got to record yourself. You got to.
Amigo.
Yes.
It's like five after. I just realized. I don't know. We need to go.
Everybody sing vibrato in.
That's
hard for
me.
That's hard.